Part 3, Company Assets and Cash Flow. The authors admit that the topics covered in this chapter are not the kind of things that are generally heard in investment discussions at cocktail parties, and may seem more like accounting issues than investment concerns, but argue that an informed investor must know when something is simply an accounting detail and when it has an impact on company earnings, and hence, investment results. Fixed assets and depreciation. A company's fixed assets typically include any property, plants, and equipment, which together are often referred to as PP&E. These assets are shown on the balance sheet at their initial cost, although we know plant and equipment wear out over time. We account for this by depreciating the value of these assets over their expected useful life. On the balance sheet, we show the original cost of the assets as the gross PP&E and subtract the accumulated depreciation to obtain the net PP&E. Depreciation is also accounted for on the income statement for a given year, but only the amount occurring in that year. Depreciation is considered a non-cash expense since there is no cash outflow and we are simply writing down the value of the asset. There are several types of depreciation, with the most common methods being straight line and accelerated. Straight line depreciation reduces the value of an asset by an equal amount each year of its useful life, whereas accelerated depreciation reduces the value more in the early years and less towards the end of an asset's life. The most important point is that an investor should always watch for changes in a company's depreciation expenses to see what impact it might have on future earnings. In addition, investors must be alert to the fact that companies can sometimes change their method of depreciation to mask a year of lower than expected earnings. Cash flow. In addition to the balance sheet and income statement, most companies provide a statement of cash flow in their annual reports. This statement is generally broken into three categories. 1. Cash flow from operations. 2. Cash flow from financing. 3. Cash flow from investing. Cash flow from operations. Cash flow from operations is the most important source of cash, and refers to cash that. It is important to note that cash flow from operations is not the same as earnings. This is because depreciation and several other non-cash expenses are subtracted from sales when calculating earnings, but are not subtracted when calculating cash flow. Thus, the easiest way to calculate cash flow from operations is to take earnings and add back any non-cash expenses. Cash flow from financing. Inflow from financing occurs from a company raising new money by issuing equity securities, common or preferred stock, or by borrowing, bank loans or bonds. Outflows occur from the repayment of principal debt amounts, the payment of both common and preferred dividends, and money spent to repurchase stock. Interest is not considered to be an outflow from financing, and is accounted for in cash flow from operations since it is paid on a regular basis. Cash flow from investing. Cash flow from investing generally refers to cash a company spends to flows into the company from selling its products or services, less the cash that flows out to pay for raw materials, wages, and other expenses necessary to run the company on a day-to-day basis. Cash flow from investing generally refers to cash a company spends to improve its business. It usually does not mean buying stock and bonds, although these would be included. From the perspective of a company, investing typically means buying new plant and equipment so that products can be made faster, better, or cheaper. These are called capital expenditures. Outflow from investing, then, includes capital expenditures as well as cash spent buying other companies, wholly or partially through stock. Inflows. include any money received for the sale of a company or any of its property, plant, and equipment. Survival needs and free cash flow. A company's survival needs include debt principal repayment requirements, maintenance level capital spending, replacing worn out and obsolete machinery, and preferred dividends. These are payments that a company must make in order to stay in business. If a company's cash flow from operations is not enough to meet these minimal needs, the company's stock is probably not a good investment. Unless there is a compelling reason to believe that it will only be short on cash for a year or two, and can finance itself in the meantime. We call the cash flow from operations that is left over after the survival needs have been met free cash flow, FCF. This is used to increase shareholder value. This can be done by increasing capital spending above the maintenance level, increasing the common dividend, repurchasing company bonds or prepaying debt, hoarding cash, or repurchasing common stock, to name a few. It is up to management to determine to the best way to use free cash flow to maximize shareholder value, and a stock's price often reflects how effectively management uses its FCF. If you enjoy this content and similar content, please consider liking, subscribing and hitting the notification icon. Please also consider seeing some of the affiliate links in the description below, and it really helps out the channel. Thank you, have a wonderful day.